We've had a few sniffs to date, but this is really really showing us the high grade gold potential, and this is really going to form the focus of our exploration for 2025 is growing this gold zone and understanding, where there might be high grade gold in other parts of our existing open pit model, as well as along strike and at depth.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Simon Dyakowski. He is the CEO of GSP Resource Corp. And Simon, it's good to see you. How are you?
Hey, doing well. Great to see you as well, Steve. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, well, you've got exciting news out about a new discovery. We'll get to that in just a second. But you're basically announcing that the final holes of a drill program that you were doing. So let's talk about project itself. Remind everyone about the project, and more importantly, what this drill program was designed to do.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're focused on the Alwin Mine project, which is in southeastern British Columbia. It is about 2 kilometers west of the Highland Valley open pit mine, which is owned and operated by Teck Resources. And what Alwin is a historic high-grade past producing copper silver gold mine. We've now acquired 100% of it as of last week, and we've been focusing over the past couple of years to develop a new open pit model, which we think will result in an expansion of the already drilled off deposit there. So we announced a resource a couple of months ago, and now we've announced the drill results of a recent drill campaign, which was designed with about 8 holes to come in and expand on the mineralization that we have already identified in the model.
Yeah, and so you've discovered a high-grade gold zone. So obviously, very positive results coming out of this drill program. Tell me a little bit about it.
Yeah, absolutely. So earlier in the week, we announced some high-grade copper. So we hit 17, nearly 17 and a half meters over 2.4% copper, 35 grams silver, 0.68 gold. So that was about 3% copper equivalent. And that's growing our in-pit copper resource. But the results that we announced on today, which is January 16th, are a new discovery of high-grade gold, which falls outside of the existing pit shell. And we drilled just under 8 meters. So 7.9 meters of 5 grams per ton gold and 1% copper. And included with that was a higher grade zone of nearly 23 grams per ton gold and 1.8% copper over 1.64. So this is very significant because it's growing the footprint of the deposit that we've delineated, and it's giving a new angle to this project. And I just really quickly want to explain this. We have over 10,000 historic copper samples in our current model, but only 33 gold samples. So what this is showing us is that there is a very significant gold aspect to this project, which has not been assayed because of a historic quirk where they were not assaying for gold in the 1960s when this was initially being drilled off and discovered. So huge upside, I think, for us.
Yeah, and even of those historical samples that you have, this represents the highest grade modern gold assay that you've seen.
Well, exactly. And we've had a few sniffs to date, but this is really really showing us the high grade gold potential, and this is really going to form the focus of our exploration for 2025 is growing this gold zone and understanding, where there might be high grade gold in other parts of our existing open pit model, as well as along strike and at depth.
So Simon, does this now change your plans for 2025 as to what you were hoping to do? Is it Legion of more drilling? Is it more geophysical work, or what sort of, or have you come to that conclusion quite yet?
Well, we're just starting to think about that, and we
Yeah.
haven't announced anything, and this is really subject to board approval and market conditions. But at first blush, I mean, I would say that we're definitely gearing in the direction of more drilling for high grade gold at this project now. It's I think now it's a known quantity, and we have lots of evidence to support the theory that there is significant gold potential at the Alwin mine.
Well, it certainly is going to be a very busy 2025 for sure. We look forward to being there to follow your story. That is Simon Dyakowski. He's the CEO of GSP Resource Corp.